This tutorial is about transport under resuscitation conditions using the corpus CPR. The whole process is a team decision that should be communicated and planned accordingly. From a technical point of view, the only thing required to do here is to check the fixation ring is firmly in place to prevent the stamp from slipping under transport. We also recommend marking the stamp position. Then you can see early on whether there is a change. In principle, when the patient is fixed on the corpus CPR, they can be moved in all directions, and the boards can be also used as a lifting aid. Verena, what else do we want to show?
I would say let's get off the podium and over to the mannequin and take a look at the whole thing in practice. We have prepared the mannequin for transport with the corpuls CPR. As we all know, moving a mannequin isn't particularly spectacular, and that's why we've already organised it. You can also see from the stamp extension that we are using the Scoopboard. That is really the only indication that we're using the Scoopboard because overall it doesn't add much bulk. We have opted for the vacuum mattress here because we find it a really good option. On one hand, it provides the corpuls CPR with more support and prevents it from slipping. And on the other hand, it's a great option for transfer to stretchers or other means of transport.
We now want to show you some movements which are representative of some transport situations under ongoing CPR. So I will start the therapy. The whole process works without problems, if you make sure that the stamp does not slip. It has not slipped a millimetre.
Now we can see the variant, with the Recboard with an alternative arm position. As you can see, this is also possible with the vacuum mattress. In summary, we can say that transport with corpuls CPR can be easily implemented undergoing ongoing resuscitation. We saw particularly with the Recboard and the Scoopboard that this also works very well with the vacuum mattress. It is important to really keep an eye on the stamp position, possibly also to mark the position, in order to see any changes as quickly as possible, especially in stairwells. There are many ways in which transport can be configured. Here we decided to use the vacuum mattress. However, how you choose to do it out on a mission depends on your circumstances and the situation. It depends on how you best manoeuvre the patient. Of course, it is advisable to practice all this beforehand. We hope we were able to give you some good tips. Until next time.